Everyone, and welcome back to set six. And today what I've got for you is I've got a video regarding the rumor of the Final Fantasy VII Netflix series, which has been doing the rounds over the last week, I'd say, and it's just been gaining momentum, and everyone's talking about it. So let's talk about it. I have got another video in the works at the minute. It's taking me a little bit longer to get through, which is a predictions video for Final Fantasy VII Remake Intermission for the DLC. That should probably drop in the next couple of days. I'm near the point of finalising that. But in the meantime, I thought, let's have a chat about this and see where it goes. Don't forget to drop a like on the video and subscribe for future content. It massively helps the channel grow and it is massively appreciated. So yeah, let's get on with it. So I feel like the first question that we should ask when we're talking about this is, do we think it's possible? Is the rumour true? So, I mean, the rumour itself, I'll just read it straight off. So the rumour itself says both of these projects will be directed by Nomura. The anime dedicated to Final Fantasy VII Remake will tell new stories that intertwine with the plot and events of the main game. The first section will be dedicated to events that precede the story of Final Fantasy VII Remake, while the second section will be dedicated to the events that occur simultaneously with the events of the game, coming to the end and also anticipating something for the future. The Kingdom Hearts anime will be much shorter, but definitely more complex. What a shock. Made entirely in CG, according to the description, it will combine multiple elements from multiple games, such as Kingdom Hearts Union X, Birth by Sleep, and even Kingdom Hearts 3. So, you know, there's another thing that the Kingdom Hearts fans have to watch to even slightly have a chance of comprehending the story, if that's true. And then finally, we get a little comment on the Final Fantasy XIV TV series, which is apparently in the final stages of making. Now, I didn't even know this was going on because I don't play 14, but one of my followers, or someone who interacted with the post even, on Twitter, kind of indicated that there was a 14 series. So that's good news for fans of Final Fantasy XIV there as well. You know, you're going to get the show that you wanted. So everyone should be happy from this. But is it going to be true? Now, given the way that Square Enix tend to go about things in recent years, and even as far back as like the early noughties they were trying to do it, I do feel like this has got a strong chance of being true. Square Enix have always wanted to push like other media, like movies and TV shows and things like that. They've tried numerous times, and let's be fair, they're probably hotter than they've ever been at the moment. Maybe, I don't know, maybe the 90s, but you know, they're up there. So this is a perfect opportunity for them to do it. And in most recent memory as well, if we look at Final Fantasy XV, the way that they tried to have all the additional media tying into everything, you then look at Final Fantasy VII Remake at the minute, and what have we got? We've got the game itself, we've got additional games coming out on mobile platforms, you know, we've got Ever Crisis, we've got the First Soldier, and on top of that, we've also got additional written material in the form of, I believe it's Tale of Two Pasts, which is the new book that's been written by, I think it's Nojima. So we can't sit here and say, oh no, they wouldn't do that. They're already doing it with Final Fantasy VII. It is already spreading out into multiple forms of media. And it has done in the past. Advent Children, it did show that they were definitely looking at stepping into that kind of area. Spirits Within as well, that was another attempt. And then most recently we've got Kingsglaive, and well, we did have Last Order, but we don't talk about Last Order. In fact, we'll talk about Last Order in a second. And that kind of brings me round to the next point, and just to clarify, I do think that this is going to happen. Like I say, all of those things that I've just said previously, you know, the track record of Square Enix for things like this, what they're already doing as far as Remake goes, they're trying to expand that story into different mediums. I think this is probably going to happen. There's a lot of talk about it as well. And the question then, do I think it's a good idea? And I'm kind of 50-50 on it. It all depends on the implementation of it. They've got examples of where they've done it wrong. I mean, if they do something like they did with Last Order, that would be appalling. Like, it'd be dreadful. Because what Last Order basically does is it takes a scene from the game and changes it so much, so dramatically, that it has an effect on the overall story. If you can, you know, if you take that seriously, it has such a massive effect on the overall story. And if they do something like that, that's going to be a problem. The other example of where they went wrong with it was Final Fantasy XV. They basically just hollowed out the story of Final Fantasy XV and put all the good stuff in the movie. Or not so much all the good stuff, but all the motivations, all of the important plot points. Well, not all, a lot of the important plot points, but you get what I'm saying. That movie, the events of that movie, Kingsglaive, regardless of how good it was, because it was really good to watch, Kingsglaive, I enjoyed it. I probably enjoyed Kingsglaive more than Final Fantasy XV. That is how good Kingsglaive was, or how bad 15, well, never mind. But yeah, they literally, if they were to take that approach and make a Final Fantasy VII Remake series that was vital to the story, vital to the overall narrative of Final Fantasy VII Remake, where if you didn't watch it, you won't understand Remake Part 2, for example. That'd be bad as well. I don't think they're going to do either of those things. I think it's less likely that they're going to do what they did with 15 because I think that lesson's been learned. As far as what they did with Last Order, again, it was pretty widely condemned when it came out, if I'm remembering it correctly, to the point where they re-retconned it in Crisis Core. Like they changed the scene again in Crisis Core because of how drastically bad it was in Last Order. That's my memory of the chain of events. I could be wrong. Please tell me in the comments if I am. But yeah, I just can't see him making that mistake again. And as long as they avoid those two pitfalls, I think it could be good. I think it will probably be good if they avoid those two pitfalls. The only other thing that you have to watch for then is Netflix, as far as adaptations go. And I'm probably timing this quite badly because the Castlevania adaptation was phenomenal. But for every Castlevania, there is a Death Note. So let's not forget that. Because that Death Note adaptation was just, it was so bad. So they're the three main pitfalls that I think, and as long as they can be avoided, and like I said, Netflix, they have been better in recent times from what I've seen. I could be wrong again, tell me in the comments. But yeah, from what I've seen, they have been better. So I think that they would do a reasonable, at least a passable job on a Final Fantasy VII Remake anime. I'm ignoring the Kingdom Hearts anime, it's not really my bag. Same with 14, don't really care about either of them. But it's good that people are getting them. Do you know what I mean? I'm happy for the fan bases that they are getting these animes. And I think one of the big things that will decide whether or not it's successful, the Final Fantasy VII Remake anime, that is what the subject matter is. And I've recently run a poll over on Twitter. It's still going now. It's not finished, but you know, there's an obvious trend towards one option. But the options that I gave were the ones that I thought were potentially the most gratifying, you know, the ones that would be the most enjoyable, the ones that would give us the most and enrich the story of Final Fantasy VII the most without damaging the story of Final Fantasy VII. So the first one of those that I thought was the Wutai War, because we've not really covered the Wutai War at all at any point. You know, it's been spoken about, we've seen little bits of it, but as far as like the bulk of the war where Sephiroth makes himself, you know, makes his name and becomes a war hero, we've seen none of that really. So that could be a really good one. It'd be action-packed, it'd be high intensity, you know, there'd be a lot of room for drama and things like that to happen. You could have a lot of hints towards like the Genova project going on in the background. You know, you see Hojo just sneaking about in the shadows, that sort of business. But you'd avoid that story completely because it doesn't get revealed at that point. So it's a non-entity, that story. It's like a little side thread that's going on, maybe. The main story is the action and the events of the Wutai War. That wouldn't impact on the story of Final Fantasy VII, I don't think, in any negative way. I don't think it could, unless they did something really stupid. But I think that could only add. Now, the next option would do the same sort of thing. It'd enrich the story, but it'd also give us access to something that we've never had access to in the West. And that'd be a story that circles around the Tur. And predominantly, it would be the story of Before Crisis. Now, Before Crisis was a mobile game that was released only in Japan. And it circles around, I think it's about a 5 or 6 year period before Final Fantasy VII. So the 5 or 6 years leading up to Final Fantasy VII. It centers around the adventures of the Turks, who we all know who the Turks are. We know Reno, we know Rude, we know Seng, we know Elena, we know Cisne. But there's a lot more to the Turks than just those characters. There are many, many, many members of the Turks, and this kind of explores a lot of those characters. We also get a lot of cameos from some characters in Final Fantasy VII. They pop up at certain points in the story. Nothing substantial, but you know, you see them. It's like a nod. That's my understanding of it, at least, anyway. The game was released episodically on mobile phones, so it definitely kind of fits that format of, you know, it's already episodic. It is already episodic in the format that it was originally created. So I would assume it could quite easily be converted into like an episodic TV show type of format. But not only that, like I say, it would give us access to a story that, on the face of it, seems extremely important to the compilation. You learn a lot about Rufus, you learn a lot about Shinra, you learn a lot about the Turks. You know, there's a lot of stuff that goes down in Before Crisis that kind of makes you sit there and think, oh, right, really, especially surrounding Rufus. So I do think it'd be a brilliant idea to bring this story in. And not so much bring it in, but, you know, give us access to it, because It is part of the compilation. I believe it is the only part of the compilation that hasn't been available to the West. I'm pretty sure that that is the case. So for it to finally become a thing would be brilliant. The one thing that makes me think it might not be this is the fact that we are apparently getting the Before Crisis story in Ever Crisis. So if there's already plans to make this story available to us, will they make it available in two formats? It is possible. A lot of people don't really do mobile gaming. That might be the, their logic on it. But we'll see. We'll have to wait and see on that one. But either way, I think it'd be good. It'd do a lot of good for the compilation. It shouldn't really be able to, like I said previously, like damage the compilation in any way. So yeah, I'd be up for that. And the next one is the big one for me. This is the one that I really hope it is. This is an idea where we get the backstory of the Setra and Genova. We get to see the calamity from the sky. We get to see the events 2,000 years ago. And the scope for what they could do with a series like this, it would be completely separated from the Final Fantasy VII universe, except for the fact that it is the birth of the Final Fantasy VII universe. Because without the events of like the Calamity of the Sky, Genova, and the Setra fighting against Genova and eventually being defeated mostly by Genova, the events of Final Fantasy VII don't really take place because it's all kind of centered around Genova and the experimentation that was done using Genova. So to learn about those events and to get that backstory would be amazing. And like I say, because it's so far removed from Final Fantasy VII, 2,000 years removed, the scope for what they could do with it would be massive. It would be absolutely massive. They could flesh out the Setra race. They could flesh out Genova. We wouldn't just be seeing Genova as like a clump of cells, basically, because that's what Genova is at Final Fantasy, at the stage of Final Fantasy VII. It's a relic, it's a clump of cells that's been used. And yeah, these cells obviously have power and have consciousness to a certain degree, but that's all they are. It's not a full living entity like Genova was. If we could see Genova in that state, we could get a proper grasp of Genova's power. But not only that, it could give us an idea of what kind of power Sephiroth might have access to. It could be like a little bit of a foreshadowing thing. I don't know. This one's probably the most interesting to me just because there's so many possibilities for what they could do with it and so many avenues they could go down with it. It's mouth-watering. It really is mouth-watering. And a few people did leave a few comments that are like character background series where we get some fleshing out of certain characters. And I think in some ways that could also be really good. So like they do like a 6-episode series, one episode on Cloud, one episode on, well, no, you couldn't do Cloud, but one episode on like Barret, one episode on Tifa, one episode on maybe an episode on Red 13. Maybe we get an episode on Yuffie. Maybe, do you know what I mean? There's so many characters they could do it for. I don't know if this is what they'd do because I think they're looking more long term than that. And plus, I think if they just do a single character episode, it'd potentially get quite boring quite quick. But you never know. It is a possibility. Personally, if I'm going to sit here and look at all of the options and give the choice of what I'd prefer, it'd be the Setra Genova series. That is 100% what I'm all about. It'd be so interesting to get all of that backstory and information on the Setra. Seeing Genova back then, like I've said, they could easily like tie something in there that's going to answer something for us later in Remake, but they could use it to enrich the Final Fantasy VII series so much. But one thing that I do think is with the Setra series, the main problem would be because it's so far removed from Final Fantasy VII Remake, you wouldn't have any of the characters that everyone loves from Final Fantasy VII. So, because of that, I don't think that's what they're going to do. And it makes me sad. It does make me sad because they're going to want to market the characters that are going to be in the story. 100% they're going to want to market the characters. And if none of the characters are in the story, then they can't do that. We can't have Cloud or Sephiroth or Aerith or any of those characters turning up back in Setra times. You know what I mean? Avalanche turn up to take down Genova. No, it's not going to happen. And that is why I don't think it is going to be that. That is the one that I would want. But I think that that is a very Final Fantasy VII fan view. And I think that they're wanting to grab more than Final Fantasy VII fans. I think they're wanting to create new Final Fantasy VII fans with this series, obviously. So for me, I think the most likely one is probably the Turks or Before Crisis or something like that, something set in that time frame, something in Midgar, where there is a chance we will see characters from Final Fantasy VII from the main story because, they live in Midgar. Everyone loves the Turks. Well, not everyone, but a lot of people love the Turks. So, it'd be instantly good from that perspective because it'd be a series set around characters that everyone kind of thinks, the aesthetic's really good, the vibe's really good. Everyone likes watching the Turtles. You might not like the Turtles, but you like watching them. You like seeing them on the screen. It's always, shit always goes down when the Turks are about, basically. So it would be a pretty action-packed series. And yeah, I think it probably is the most likely. It ties into the narrative of Final Fantasy VII the closest. Wutai War is a possibility as well. Like I say, it would be nice to get some backstory on how Sephiroth became the war hero that he became, see some more of the events around the war. We get to see Shinra not in the dominant position that it is in, that we see it in Remake. Because in Remake and in Final Fantasy VII, when we see Shinra, everything's done. They've done it. They've taken over the world. Whereas during the Wutai War, while they've probably got most of the world, they're still not that entirely dominant power yet. It'd be a good watch to see how that happened and how Soldier kind of swung the balance in favor of Shinra and made it possible. But I think I've rambled on enough about this, so quick overview. Yes, I do think the rumor's true. I do think we are probably going to see a Netflix series now that I've kind of sat and thought about it for a bit. Do I think it should be done? As long as they do it right, yeah, why not? Like, genuinely, why not? As long as they avoid the pitfalls that I've kind of already gone over, and I think they will, I do think they will, then yeah, why not? And what do I think it could be? Like I say, I'd prefer it to be the Setra Genova show. The Setra Genova show, that's the name. That is the name. But it's probably going to be Turks or Before Crisis. Or something in that time frame, something in Midgar. Something that ties into the story. That's what I think. But what about you? What do you think? Don't forget to leave your thoughts in the comments below. Tell me what you think this Netflix series could be. I know a lot of people hate the idea of it, and I kind of did at first initially. I thought about it a little bit more, and as long as it's good, I mean. But it all depends on it being good. But let me know what you think. Do you think this is Square Enix going too far? Do you think it's going to be brilliant? Do you think we should get more stuff like this? Drop them in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe. But more importantly than anything, have a great day.